After Deepwater Horizon oil spill, microbe came to our help. They were the first respondents after the oil spill and led on to remediation of significant amount of hydrocarbon after the oil spill. But here what we've been working on and focusing on in particular is that how surfactants can modify these forces on interaction. We looked at bacteria near liquid-liquid and gas-liquid interfaces, and we saw that bacteria attracting close to gas-liquid surface even more than liquid-liquid interface. And from the theories that was out there in the literature, we couldn't explain it, that they predict the opposite. Why do we see more bacteria acclimating near gas-liquid interface? Our theory that we developed to be able to explain that shows that if we have some surfactants there, that changes the interface properties so that gas interface can even be slightly more attractive. When we add surfactants, the microbes spend more time near the oil droplet, so it's actually helping potentially bioremediation. We know that after on the oil spill, 7 million liters of dispersants were added. And at that time, like, none of these details were known. So now here we are discovering a new mechanism where surfactants can also lead to increased hydrodynamic interaction of bacteria with oil droplets. And that combined with chemotaxis can increase residence time of bacteria near these nutrient sources. Potentially they will have more time to decompose hydrocarbon. I love mathematics and doing even calculation with pen and paper. I also love physics and understanding what are the physical mechanisms involved. I also love doing experiments. I feel fluid dynamics, especially at these scales, all of these skill sets come into play, and you can use all of them to discover new phenomena and new physics.